With me here in the studio from Mayfair 101, I'm joined by James Mawhinney and Mark Cliffe. Good to see you both. Thanks very much indeed for coming in.
Thanks, Andrew.
James, look, some big news. I'll let you do the introductions here. Tell me what's been happening at Mayfair 101.
Yeah, sure, Andrew. As always, we've been very busy, but I'm delighted to announce that Mark Cliffe, to my left, has just joined our advisory board for the group globally.
Right. Well, Mark, tell me a bit more about yourself.
Well, I'm the chief economist for ING Bank on a global basis. I've had a career of over 30 years in financial services, so advising clients of all kinds, in fact, over the years about the state of the economy and the financial markets.
Mm. And what are the opportunities that you can see at Mayfair 101?
Well, I think what's interesting about this is that people are really struggling with what's happening in the public markets right now. The valuations look challenging, and I think people are looking for new kinds of investment products that can deliver them a decent return with limited risk. And I think this is really where, you know, Mayfair 101 has got something to offer.
Well, indeed. And James, tell me a little bit more from your perspective, the fit for market Mayfair.
Yeah, so I think there's two sides to our business. We really sit as a conduit between investors that are looking for better returns than what they're traditionally getting. The majority of our investors have typically had money traditionally with a lot of the traditional financial institutions. And on the other side, we've then also got the businesses that we deploy capital to. Now, if you look at really a traditional bank model, it is effectively the same thing. You've got deposit makers that deposit funds with the bank. The bank then manages that money and deploys that out. Now what's happened is as a result of the global financial crisis in 2008, there's been a lot of tightening up of bank lending policies, both imposed by the banks themselves, plus obviously the government and the regulators. What that's meant is that the banks have actually pulled back on a lot of the investments that they have done. And so what that's done is it's left a big gap for organisations like us that are effectively the newer breed of conduit to really fill that gap. And so it's important for us not just to be offering investment products that make sense, but equally as important to have people like Mark involved to help us steer our business and our group on behalf of our investors to make sure that we're investing in the right areas. We're very sensitive to macroeconomic trends. And ultimately that we're delivering value to everyone that's involved.
And I suppose, Mark, just to build on that, stepping in, capitalising on the opportunity in the market, where are those opportunities?
Well, I think, you know, people are looking for something different here. As I mentioned, I think the public markets are looking a bit challenged. You've got bond yields, which in many parts of the world are actually zero or even negative. So that's tough for investors, and equity markets have had a tremendous run over the last few years, and now they're looking a bit more challenged. So you've got to look for, you know, private opportunities. You've got to look at real assets. So you've got to be spreading your net a bit wider, I think, to get a decent return.
And James, a final thoughts?
Yeah, well, I think to Mark's point a minute ago about spreading a bit wider as a group, certainly in the last year or two, we have started doing exactly that, where, as you both are aware, we originally focused quite heavily in the fintech sector because it's robust relative to particularly what's going on around the world at the moment. When you're investing in businesses that are rolling out in emerging markets, where there's an enormous demand for capital and there's demonetization occurring at great rates, these businesses are quite insulated from that, but at the same time, it's equally as important, particularly with Mark's insights, to make sure that we are very well diversified. And so we've been taking steps progressively over the last couple of years to make sure that we've got a really well-balanced portfolio.
James, Mark, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew.